हेलो फ्रेंड्स, वेलकम टू क्रिएटिव मेडिसिन। इन दिस लेक्चर वी विल लर्न अबाउट
हेलो फ्रेंड्स, लेट अस नाउ लर्न सम इम्पॉर्टेंट पॉइंट्स अबाउट फल्मिनेंट हेपेटिक फेलियर। सो व्हाट डू यू सी इन फल्मिनेंट हेपेटिक फेलियर? In fulminant hepatic failure, toxins are more responsible for fulminant hepatic failure than viral hepatitis, which can be hepatitis D and hepatitis E, especially in pregnancy, is associated with fulminant hepatic failure. Okay, so in the toxicity, in the toxins, you will see there is paracetamol toxicity can cause fulminant hepatic failure. Amanita or mushroom poisoning. Amanita or mushroom poisoning can result in fulminant hepatic failure. Halothane can result in fulminant hepatic failure. ATT, which is anti-tubercular drug, which is pyrazinamide, will result in fulminant hepatic failure. So, this fulminant hepatic failure occurs less than 8 weeks of liver insult. That is, it occurs very fast. So here the main important thing is you will see presence of encephalopathy will be seen, plus or minus coagulopathy are the main important features of fulminant hepatic failure. Then we also have subfulminant hepatic failure. What is subfulminant hepatic failure? Subfulminant hepatic failure. Subfulminant hepatic failure is seen in 8 to 26 weeks. In subfulminant hepatic failure, the jaundice will worsen and bleeding will also be present. Okay, now let us now learn the clinical features of hepatic failure. Whether it is fulminant or subfulminant, the clinical features will almost be similar. In fulminant, they are abrupt. In subfulminant, they will be slowly, they will come gradually. So clinical features of hepatic failure include: one, jaundice, definitely it will be present. Then hypoalbuminemia will be seen. This will predispose to peripheral edema. Then there will be hyperammonemia. You will see presence of hyperammonemia will be seen. Then there will be foetal hepaticus. Now, why foetal hepaticus? Because the gastrointestinal bacteria which are present in the intestine, gastrointestinal bacteria will act on the sulfur containing amino acid methionine. It acts on sulfur containing amino acid methionine. Once it acts on sulfur containing amino acid methionine, it produces mercaptans, and these mercaptans are responsible for this foetal hepaticus or bad odor. Then there will be palmar erythema. You will see presence of palmar erythema, and spider angioma are seen. These are mainly due to impaired estrogen metabolism. Then you will see the presence of because estrogen metabolism occurs in liver. Here there is liver cell failure, so increased estrogen, so it causes palmar erythema and spider angioma. Then you will also see presence of hypogonadisms and gynecomastia are also seen. These are actually caused due to hyperestrogenism. These are caused due to hyperestrogenemia. then there will be susceptibility to failure of many organ systems will also occur, not just due to liver failure. The other organ systems can also fail. Like for example, if there can be respiratory failure along with the liver failure, and second, there can also be renal failure can be there along with the hepatic failure. Okay, then there will be coagulopathy. In the coagulopathy, this is mainly attributed to blood clotting factors. It is seen mainly due to blood clotting factors like 2, 7, 9, 10. Synthesis is impaired because the synthesis of these occurs in liver. So the synthesis of these blood clotting factors are impaired, causing coagulopathy. Next. These are clinical features, very good. But if there are two complications can be the most grave stage of hepatic failure. These two complications include, one, it can be due to hepatic encephalopathy or hepatorenal syndrome. So this is about important points about hepatic failure. Thank you for watching.
Thank you for watching.